Before moving to discuss other memory ordering options, let's first discuss the instruction reordering a bit. Now this diagram shows you the von Neumann architecture of the computers, which was introduced in the 1940s. Now this is the simplest as it can be, and we love to program to this model. This processor will read one instruction at a time and do read or write operation or the calculation based on that instruction before moving on to the next instruction. So there's no reordering can happen anywhere in this model. Now let's see the simplified architecture of the processor available in the today's market. Now as you can see from this diagram, the current processor architectures have way more complicated architecture than von Neumann architecture. Now these processors have multiple level of caches, store buffers and so on. In fact, if you take modern processor, more than 80% of the transistors in the processor dedicated to optimize the memory access and keep memory buffer busy at all the time possible. For example, one of the earliest optimizations that chip designers made, adding store buffer because writing value to the memory take longer time than the reading. Now these store buffers will store writes and flush it all together. Therefore, there may be scenarios when working on the different variables, even though the write to the variable happen before reading another variable in the source code, write may execute after the read because of these store buffers. Now let's see where this reordering of the code can happen. Now as you can see from this diagram, there are many things can happen between the source code and actual code which is going to execute. Compilers may perform sub-expression elimination, and in the cache, for sure there are store buffers which reorder the write or the store the writes, and processor may prefetch instruction, or speculation can happen, or overlap writes can happen in the processor as well. Now as you can see from here, multiple level of reordering can occur until the instruction execution. Now let's see possible reordering examples. And now this diagram shows you one possible transformation of source code into the optimized code. As you can see here, in the source code, in between storing value 5 to the x and storing value 9 to the x, there are no read or fetch. Therefore, compiler can eliminate the first write to the x because the outcome will be same. Now, and what about this reordering? Exchanging inner and outer loop of the access to two-dimensional array. Is this valid reordering? The answer is yes. Now, depending on your memory layout, compiler will decide which of these access the memory layout linearly. Hence, it can transform this code into this code. Okay, now you know that there are much more going internally to optimize what you write. And this is perfectly okay since it gives you same result as what you wrote in the code. Now in the multi-threaded environment, if multiple threads access shared variables, we have to explicitly mention to the compiler about the mutual exclusive access. That's what we did using mutexes in the first section. Now these mutex not only provide the mutual exclusive access, but they also restrict the memory ordering of the code as well, to provide the thread safety. So you can consider mutex and memory ordering options that we are going to discuss here as a way of imposing restriction of reordering these instructions as well. So that's it for this video. From next video onward, we will again start our discussion on memory ordering options.